Hello, Lynne.
Hello again.
Welcome.
Oh, hello. It's really nice to be here. Thank you.
Oh, it's lovely to have you. I've been chuckling quite a lot in the last few days preparing for this interview and reading and rereading some of your work.
Thank you.
But apart from chuckling, it's really occurred to me, and talking about extraordinary people, mm-hmm. how extraordinarily varied your writing career has been. Not only you have worked in various contexts, mm-hmm. but you know, you've moved seemingly effortlessly, I think, from comedic, mm-hmm. nearly slapstick writing, perhaps, mm-hmm. The Brighton-based yeah. crime novels. Before that, obviously, books about language. Mm-hmm. More seriously, perhaps, your work about pilgrimage and travel. Mm-hmm. So there's a real variety, and I just wondered if you find it fun, or if it's something that you feel that you need to do and explore.
I do wonder sometimes. Someone once told me an old Yorkshire saying, which is "stick with your knitting," which means, you know, do what you're good at and stick with it. And I've never done that. I've always been interested, but usually people approach me and say, "Would you like to try this?" And I always say, "Yeah, I really would." And I think the sports writing being a thing in case in point was came out of nowhere. I was a TV critic and I was on the Times. And I was asked, would you like to try sports writing during Euro 96, which is now an extremely long time ago. I realised
that... Which you didn't know existed
I'd never heard of the European Championships. I didn't know they were every 4 years. I thought they might be every year. I didn't know anything about football at all. And, I think versatility is something I prize in a career. And I like the craft of writing. I think maybe for me that's the point, is that I really like thinking, what sort of piece is this? It's something for radio, you write it this way. If it's a drama, obviously, you
because
write it.
Quite
it's very
different.
And I really like practicing different types of craft. So at the moment, I'm writing these crime novels, which have a narrator, quite strong characters, and are supposed to be funny. So that's another thing. That's another thing I'm enjoying doing.
Right.
It was very hard for me, sorry, but when I was characterised as only interested in apostrophes, you can imagine how annoying that was to me, because I've always liked doing lots of different things.
I know, and you don't want to be known as the apostrophe queen anymore.
No, I would have
loved to be known as the apostrophe queen. And obviously, I don't know, is it a little bit annoying for you that it shoots and leaves keeps coming? You know, obviously I had to introduce you as the author of that, and wherever you go, people will talk about that. I loved that book. Mm. I read it a long time ago. For me, the funniest book of all was the sports one, Get Her Off the Pitch, because and I didn't know about this part mm-hmm. of your career until I read that book. And I think your writing is funny anyway, but I think kind of the element of surprise in that book and your honesty that, you know, about mm-hmm. not having a clue about football and or about sports in general. And then you know, and then the sort of very funny bits that made you love the whole thing and love the process.
It was a really interesting period, and I'm so glad you like that book, because it sort of came out in, I don't know, 10 years ago or something, and it's not well known.
Right.
I think, you know, as a writer, you have to accept which ones make a hit and which ones don't. And obviously, Shoots and Leaves was sort of massive, so I benefited from that. I'm very lucky to have written a book that has such success. I'm very pleased in a way that it's receding in time. It was 2003, so I can sort of... I never, ever comment, if I'm asked on the by radio news people to comment on some new grammatical lapse or...
You don't want to.
You know, I never, ever do it. I don't want to reinforce that idea that I'm only interested in apostrophes. So, but I am very lucky to have had it.
Right, and we can't not talk about it. I just have to tell you that this book, the Get Her Off the Pitch, physically, I was drinking tea while reading it, and, you know, the whole thing, every now and again, I've heard comments like, we talked about a boxer, the boxer's wearing a belt, and then you just add something like, you know, they tragically don't go with anything else, and loved it. But It Shoots and Leaves was... Mm-hmm. You know, a real phenomenon, because it mm-hmm. is a book about punctuation. Mm. In fact, it's the zero tolerance approach to punctuation. Yeah. And I know you're not as serious about these things, but you do describe yourself in the book as a stickler, mm-hmm. and you do say us sticklers are not alone. And and I can relate to that.
Yeah.
And English is not even my native language, and yet mm-hmm. I do notice these apostrophes when they're not in place, not just even punctuation, but, you know, I don't know, when people say would of instead of would have, mm-hmm. etc. instead of etc. I notice these things. I get annoyed, and I know that you kind of want to move away from that.
Yes.
But surely it is something that's on your mind.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think I'm less of a stickler than some of my fans. But of course, yes, I do. I have always noticed things. I trained as a sub-editor, and I think at that stage in my life, it wasn't until I was working as a journalist that I started obviously becoming someone who spotted mistakes, because that's what sub-editors do. And copy, you know, proofreading and so on, you're looking for mistakes. And so you start to train your mind to look for them, and then there's no going back.
Right.
And when I wrote the book, it was to be about punctuation, but I knew it was also about that feeling that people have of enrage, you know, they're enraged when they see some mistake, which they're powerless to change. They have no idea why people don't know that it should be would have instead of would of. And so I wanted to write about that feeling as well. And I think that's possibly why it caught on so much.
Lynne, thank you so much for coming to the studio. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you very much. Yeah, it's been great.